Think immigration officer process is based on a free form or something. No, it's way more than that. Usually that's what I think. I thought. So I thought it's like submit the document and that's all. Yeah, but it's a no. If you have to put this, and even at the end of the whole thing, the letter that was forwarded to me that I should read through, I was like, this detail, if I should do it myself, I won't write all this. This must be a lawyer. Yes. Then I gave him I said, defending each part, writing in detail like this. No. These people are professionals. I told myself that if I should apply by myself, I can't write all this.
Yeah, that's what we do. You know, we had a letter from our office where we explain to himself why you should give that letter to that officer. And that letter goes a long way in helping to get results. Because, one, if it goes, if the officer goes through it, they understand everything about you. And it doesn't need to go through too many things to say, this is what is there, this is what is there, and most times I think it works for us, and it works for you also. You know, and that's what we do. We also share the document with our clients so they can see it, read it, and review it. You know, okay, look at what we have done for you. That's why I heard some people push us and say, something that doesn't work. We need time to write all those things and review the things we have given to us. Then come up with the documents that we're going to submit. It's not just filling forms and submitting. But you know, we have to review all those documents. After reviewing them, write about each of them and send it in. So it takes time to do all those things. Well, so you want to do a good job, not just wishy washy job where you just write anything and send it. You know, so that's it. You know. We're still happy that you are here in Canada, because we are together in Bradford.
I'm sorry.
I think those names are, you know, and I'm so happy about that.
It's
eventually,
by the day I received a call, that morning it was like, is that Mrs. Oluwaleke? It's coming from today, and Mr. Lavender was like, wow, what is what's the news? I don't know what to say. Crash out. Because, you know, something I've been longing for in a very long time, and doesn't come to be like, let it be. But thank God that through link, and God backing you up.
Yeah. Let me go back to the video we call, but I know I called you to tell you that your visa has been approved. I've done a lot of calls, but I've done so many calls with many people. You know, you're one of those I did with also. You know, some people keep saying those calls were arranged.
So before then, when I watched your Instagram and I followed the Instagram that I did, I hope it's not that the picture of people that they know. True, sometimes I'll be like, so that day I received the call, I was like, is he really? Within me, I was asking that question. Is it true? Is it true? Could it be true? Is it true? And that was why I don't know what to say. I was like, within me, I was like, is it true? But thank God it's.
Yeah, it's
true.
So you can hear her, you know, we called her to tell her about the approval.
Yeah.
Then today we are live here
in
Ontario, Canada, talking live.
You can see live.
now this is live, whatever, it's not audio, whatever, you know, so people felt, okay, it's almost listening on the radio, that it's not arranged. She's now here saying what we need, you know, we are together in Canada, sitting beside each other in
Bradford, Ontario,
where she's schooling and we are talking together here. We're happy about that. One other question I was asking you, who said it's so difficult for those over 40 years to get visas to Canada? You know, I want to assume you're less than 30 years, that's why you're visa was
I'm over 40, I'm 45 years, I will be 46 this year by God's grace. So maybe age, I don't know, maybe age is a factor to...
But for you,
it's not a factor.
Yeah, so that's what I'm saying. It's not for us, for us too. It's not age is not a factor for us. We've got some research for people older than you. We've got because of the teaching you have.
She said, well, remember, I have a woman in my class that is even older than me.
So as soon as they will understand what you're going to do and be able to put it together well to convince yourself, sir, it's something that we have done successfully for many people, and no matter your age, we can get you to come
That's true.
So what's your experience like in Canada? You know, at least you've been there for a while now, and do you want to share the experience with people?
Experience coming to Canada to study. The study that is quite different from Nigeria.
It's so easy, you don't have to.
It's so easy.
It's easy?
Easy. In the sense that you have your course material, you have every detail of what you want to read.
You have access to it easily.
Access to it easily.
Yeah.
The professors are there to put you through, even in in-person class. They will teach you as if they are teaching kindergarten. They will teach you as if they are teaching kindergarten. Only that you have many assignments. You have weekly discussion posts. You have group projects. And before you put all this together, it takes time. Apart from that,
it's
part of grooming and part of learning.
When your funds is still coming from abroad, that is so easy. In my opinion, it's a phase. By the time one is transferring into the other phase, things might be much easier. By the time you're working full time and all that, things will just be more better. Or like when you're working as a student, or sorting out things as a student,
it's so easy. But after getting the visa, I remembered there were some mails that were sent to me. What I need to do? How do I need to go about getting myself back there? So, and those information are very important, because if I have not had this, I won't know I need those papers. And it was forwarded to me. I was able to put them together. So,
apart from helping you with visa, with admission, was there anything that you got from the team?
The issue of accommodation, that aspect, in fact, I don't know what to do about families. Truly, I have not stressed about living in Nigeria. I was like, hey, where would I stay? I don't know anybody in Canada, I don't know anybody. So, immediately, I just received a call from Mr. Lagrada. Was like, where are you now? I said, I'm on my way to the embassy. Okay, I will link you with someone. So when you call her, she'll get to where to stay. And she sends the message. Even when I go to Toronto Airport, I call the woman. She ping and said, I can't come and pick you, but just locate this address. She sent the address to me. So that was how I was able to get a taxi. And I got there and was able to stay with her. And that really solved the problem of accommodation from there. She put me through on what to do and how to go about my way in Canada. Make it easy. Though getting accommodation sometimes can be, but at least not that I was standard at it,
Any final words for audience who are watching this video?
Yes. Well, I want to say that truly, it's really true. It's really true. A true agency that can handle immigration issue perfectly. I knew how they have gone through my own papers and the documents and how they handled it. So I can only say yes, they are professionals.
Thank you very much. What a pleasure again for taking time to talk to us. We're happy that we assisted you to get admission and also process of visa. We're happy that you are finally coming out. So, I also especially thank you for coming out to talk to us about our services. Wish you the best in your endeavors and pray that all your heart desires to be accomplished very soon. All the things you are prepared to achieve. Everything will be perfect soon, by God's grace. We should be best in all you do and do your husband also.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it too for coming.